Before you rises an obelisk of hewn sandstone, solitary and ancient. The monolith's surface is etched with the brutal reality of time, but a rune of sapphire nestled at its heart pulses with a serene light, untouched by the centuries. Drawn by the intoxicating power the rune emanates, you step closer, squinting against light. Each step throws your shadow against the towering stone, dwarfing you, yet infusing you with a sense of determination. With cautious reverence, the hero extends a gloved hand, his fingers brushing the obelisk. The coolness of the sandstone against his palm is a stark contrast to the power emanating from the rune. He hesitates, then presses his hand fully onto the sapphire rune. The immediate rush of power is like a cold stream cascading through his veins, a tingling sensation that left him momentarily breathless. He can feel the essence of the rune surging through him, weaving its magic into the very fabric of his being. A quiet gasp escapes him as his senses are washed in the magic's vibrancy, the sensation filling him with a vitality he had not felt in years. A colossal axe swings like a pendulum with a force that belies the absence of any hand to wield it, a sentinel denying you passage. It's clear an enchantment lies upon it, old magic, fashioned to keep intruders at bay. Someone will have to disrupt the magic to ensure safe passage. Who will attempt to disrupt the magic? The hero whispers the words of an incantation. For a moment, it seems as though the axe slows in its swing. But then, with a resonant hum, it continues its rhythmic arc, the powerful magic refusing to yield. The stone form of the Reaper stands tall and ominous, a stark reminder of the cycle of life and death. Clad in a robe that drapes over its skeletal form, its bony hand clutches a scythe, the ubiquitous symbol of its office. It is as though the Reaper himself watches, his hooded skull turned slightly, giving the uncanny impression of an eternal gaze. The cold, unfeeling visage seems to regard you with an indifference that is profoundly unsettling. At the feet of the Reaper, a stone basin is filled with dark, congealing blood, an offering from those desperate to stave off their own mortality. Surrounding the basin, candles flicker like distant stars against the pitch-black cloak of the Reaper, casting dancing shadows upon the stone. The air hangs heavy with the scent of wax and iron. Judge not a life until its final breath, for the Reaper's touch brings truth to death. resting upon an ancient stone plinth, you discover a horn, grand and ornate, that seems to sing with an unseen power. It is enormous, constructed of what appeared to be bone or perhaps ivory, sheathed in fine metals and studded with twinkling jewels. Its dwarven craftsmanship is evident in the meticulous detailing, the intricate patterns that wound their way around the horn like a visual symphony. You've heard tale of such horns of battle, artifacts that summon allies when sounded, or enemies. What will you do? The sound that erupts is deep and rich, rolling across the landscape like a war drum. It echoes off the mountains, filling the air, the ground, your very bones with its call. Then, silence. A heavy, waiting silence. The echoes of the horn call still ringing in your ears, but everything else seems eerily quiet. And then, you hear it. The steady march of war, the cry of battle, the clatter of armaments. The call has been answered.
Thank you.
victory was hard-won and bittersweet. The cavern floor is littered with fallen foes, and you bear numerous injuries. But you are alive, and have proven yourself against a horde of summoned enemies. You have faced the call of the battle, and emerged victorious. Victory has left you sharper, stronger, and more experienced.